Angel Feather's got an amazing support booster set in her first set in Ultra Rare, so let's see what kind of deck we can build today. Anchor Fighters, last time we talked about the Gold Petalin deck that we can build in Ultra Rare's Miracle Collection, and today we're going to look at the opposite side of the spectrum and take a look at Angel Feathers. And this is a literal counter to the Gold Petalin deck that is quite weird because it's a Protect clan, and usually Gold Petalin as an Exo clan should have the edge against a Protect clan, but because of the both, how the VRs work, they basically are mirroring each other, but more on that when we talk about the cards themselves. Angel Feather itself, we're known with their mechanic in the old sets where they are manipulating the damage zone and they are basically having two hands. One that is actually their hand and one that is the damage zone because they have access to all the cards in it. And we can definitely see that again with this first support wave in Standard. But they even went a step further. Not only can we manipulate the cards from our damage zone, we also have access from cards from our drop zone. Meaning that whenever a card is removed from the deck, so it's somewhere else besides from the deck, we can have access to it. And that makes Angel Feathers one of the most consistent decks to date in Standard. So let's see what kinds of amazing things they can do and how we can manage to play the deck to the most optimized way in today's deck profile. And again, if you're only interested in certain sections of the video, then check out these timetables that are on the left of me and go to one of the sections. Otherwise, just stick around because we're jumping right into this Angel Feathers deck profile. For this Angel Feathers deck list, we run a total of 10 grade 3s, 11 grade 2s, 12 grade 1s, and 17 grade 0s. So a lot of grade 3s in this deck, but for obvious reasons that we'll get to later in this video. So our lineup consists of 4 copies of Solidify Celestial Zerahue, and this is our main boss monster of the deck, the main VR, and it allows us to get multiple protect markers throughout the game from the damage zone as well if we rewrite it. So it's an obvious include that helps us to sustain into the late game. We also run 4 copies of Crimson Impact Metatron. This is basically our main rewrite target, and it allows us to get free heals, free rear guards, power, pressure, and everything that you want from this, from a good grade 3 ride target, as you also generate some counter charts, so she's an all-around great card. Lastly, of the grade 3s, we also run 2 copies of Mobile Hospital Feather Palace, and this is basically our finisher card of the deck that can generate waterfall-like pressure attacks onto our opponents with the crit, the power increase, and also the guard restrict. So that's a very good include on basically every Angel Feathers deck for a long time. For grade 2s, we run 3 copies of Rear Impetus Celestial Armorati, and this one allows us to fill up the field from a damage zone, getting those key units that already were into the damage zone, so great obvious include into this deck. We also run 3 copies of Wildshot Celestial Rayquil. She is somewhat similar to Armorati, similar skills, similar condition, but this one allows us to get things from the drop zone. So combining those two together, we can basically get cards, rear guards from anywhere as long as they are out of the deck. So those two together allows us to run any kind of cards to a lower count. That's why I run both only 3 copies, because I can basically fetch anything that I want to. I also run 3 copies of Million Ray Pegasus. This is a great beat stick that can generate high columns because we might have some issues with the lower attack numbers of most of our grade 2s. And it also can be a very good interceptor when we already took some damage. So a very good all-round card. I also run 2 copies of Doctoroid Aether. And this is my personal take on a deck that I really like this card. It generates good hit pressure that the opponent really doesn't want to get through, and also if it gets through, we get some free draw for that matter, and that's always very nice to have some extra draw into a deck that doesn't really plus on the hand as much as most protect lands. As for our grade 1 lineup, it's very basic. We got 4 copies of 1000 Ray Pegasus. This is our main booster and the one that can generate high columns, especially with feather pellets. We also run 4 copies of Underlane Celestial Hasidil. This is the main grade 1 card of the deck and the main card that will generate all for most of our plays, because it can swap any kind of card back into our hand, and we can place our VR into the damage zone so we can use our VR whenever we want. We also run 4 copies of Marking Celestial Arahaki. And personally, I'm not really fond of this card, but it's a lack of any better alternative. Her upside is that she can help us refresh the damage zone if we don't have any good cards in our damage zone. So she has some use to it, but I honestly have rather something else, maybe another another superior call something, or maybe another damage check something. I'm not really that fond of this card, but as stated, it's a lack of better alternative. For our grade 0 lineup, we run, of course, the draw starter first, 8 Celestial Peniel, and the trigger lineup is 8 crit, 4 heals, and 4 draw RPGs. So nothing really special there. So as total, as I stated before, our complete lineup consists out of 10 grade 3s, 11 grade 2s, 12 grade 1s, and 17 grade 0s. On to the combos. Alright, ironically, even though angels are known for the skill chaining and resource management and all the crazy things they can do with their damage zone, you might be surprised that for the first two segments of this video there isn't much to go over. Angel Feathers doesn't have a combo to play besides their finisher, Thousand Ray Hospital Attack, that can become 53k column with a crit and a sentinel block by combining Feather Palace, Thousand Ray Pegasus, and the plus 3k of Zerah Heal. But that's about it. None of the other cards combos with each other. That just they just support each other. Nothing really special about that, because these cards allows us to put new cards into the damage zone to activate all these cards. But because most cards demand that we call them from hand, means that we can change skills with Armiati and Rakuel. Resources in angels is also a non-existent issue, because if we look at the soul, we have these two that uses it, and we run a total of 5 cards, so we can safely say that we can probably use their skill whenever we want. We also have the mobile hospital that requires 2 grade 3s to be soul blasted, but if we take a look at Zerah Heal, we can see that that won't be an issue as well. Now let's take a look at Counterblast, because we have a lot that uses it, or cards that put a card face down, so also a Counterblast result effect. But all these cards allows you to take a card from the damage zone and move it to your hand, field, drop zone, etc. But they don't specify that the card needs to be face up. So in practice, you always pick the cards that are face down. This will result in the fact that all these skills are free. You only need to be able to pay the cost in advance. These are the only cards that work differently. Zerah Heal demands that it's face up, so it will result in an extra face down card in our damage zone. Thousand Ray Pegasus and Rakuel are the only literal counterblast cards in your deck. And you want to use these effects or Zerah Heal first, because you then have a face down card in your damage zone that you can abuse with all the other cards. If you aren't switching a face down card with the other effects, you're basically wasting counterblast that you actually shouldn't have had to waste. Metatron is a card that looks like a card with a heavy cost, but if we look closely, we can see that this card is completely free as long as we can pay for the initial cost. We can superior call one of the counterblast cards and then heal the other counterblast card, making this skill refund itself. Also, Metatron can generate a countercharge each turn with a rescue-like ability, making her vital card in these clutch situations. Finally, we have Feather Palace. This card forces us to turn every damage face down, meaning after resolving a skill, we can pay for other skills, because we have no open counterblast. This, however, doesn't affect cards like Feather Palace, because we don't need to pay for initial counterblast cost. But if we're sitting on Metatron, we can then generate new counterblasts with our skill, making it possible to use certain skills again. Although resources won't be an issue by nature of the clan itself, you need to learn how to use skills in the right order, timing, and moment to play without any hinder. When you master this, Angel Feather's only problem will be the dreaded 50th card. Again, ironically, most of the deck strategies that this deck has is told in the resource segment, because this deck revolves around the damage zone, meaning that gameplay and resources are intermingled to the point that there is almost no distinction between the two. So as stated before, learn to use these skills most effectively that you are hardly using any counterblast. If there are no good cards to call from a damage zone, but you have them in hand, then swap them out with Haste the Deal. Try to use every counterblast possible when you're going to use Feather Palace, to not waste too many counterblasts with its skill. The deck never shuffles itself, so remember which card you're putting back with Metatron, because believe it or not, with all the great freezes you're going to write and the extra heals you're going to get, you're getting to the very end game in most matches. So those last triggers you're stacked are going to matter in those final turns. My final strategy tip that I can give to you guys is play against your opponent's engine. Well, duh. No. Hear me out on this one. Most clans have these grade 1s and 2s special skills that cost a counterblast that will start most of their engines, like Oracle Think Tank, Grand Blue, and Kagero. All other decks can play around this effectively, because you're going to attack with your Vanguard, because not attacking will mean no drive check. And in most cases, you can only attack their Vanguard, so unless your Vanguard is weaker and you don't get a trigger, they are going to activate these skills. But angels can disrupt this quite effectively. How, you ask? Well, not by riding to your grade 1 and all, and swing with a grade 0 Vanguard, and unless you get a trigger, you won't hit.
And this sounds nuts, but because we have these two cards, we can afford it. Because next turn, we ride up to grade 1, put a Zerahiel into our damage zone, and when they ride up to grade 3, we can superiorize Zerahiel from the damage zone to close the gap. Also, we can recover some early damage with Metatron, and the consistent protect markers allows us to close the potential gap. I won't say it's always the best outcome, but our opponent won't know if we did it on purpose or that we actually are great stuck. Also, as you saw, these two cards basically remove the great stuck problem because we can always catch up to them. This deck has a lot of options. You can change your great free lineup quite a bit. You don't have to run 4-4-2. You can run 4-3-3s or 3-4-3s, maybe even 4-4-1. It all depends on your preferences. I want to note, as Kenji Shiratsuki pointed out, Petrol Phoenix is a card that can become very useful if Perfect Guard restriction cards are going to be used more and more in the future support. For grade 2s, same story. You can run 4-4-4 if you aren't a fan of Doctoroid either. But so far, the other grade 2s aren't that valuable enough to run in my opinion. And for the grade 1s, I think this is it what you're going to run for now, but you can try to tag in a single copy of Syringe Lesser. It can make two attacks hit more, or importantly, it can turn your 53k thousand ray hospital attack into a 63k thousand hospital attack. This Angel Feather deck is at first glance a very simple deck with no combos or skill chaining, but after a good inspection, one can soon deduce that this deck requires a lot of practice to master all the different skills to min-max all your resources. But in capable hands, this deck can become a powerhouse that isn't easy to take down, and that can hit hard in the late game. With their effective damage zone manipulation and free healing, they've become a protector clan that is to be feared.
And that wraps up our Angel Feathers deck profile. As I stated before, most of the segments, like the combo segment and the resources segments, aren't really that in depth because there isn't a lot to go around. But the combo aspect and the way that we're going to use the skills is mostly the main focus of the deck and the way that we're going to learn ourselves to min-max every kind of skill to their full potential. And that is going to showcase the difference between a pro Angel Feather player and a new beginner in Angel Feathers. And that's also the fun and exciting part about the clan. You're definitely going to see yourself being better and better with the clan as more games you're playing and more progressing towards your experience with the clan. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know in the comments down below what you think of Angel Feathers and what you think about this particular deck profile in the comments down below. As always guys, if you liked the video, then why not leave a like, thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, hitting the bell button down below to be updated with our new videos, and of course our upcoming deck profile for Neo Nectar that's coming right out in the corner. And otherwise, just stick around to our other content that we're going to release very soon. I'm Mr. Time Leap, and see you guys in the next one.